I'm now joined by Conservative MP Kwasi Kwarteng. Hello, Kwasi.
Hi,
thanks for joining
you?
Us. I'm good, thank you. Now, great. You've been in the Commons this week debating
Absolutely.
Brexit. It was an inspiring and insightful debate. Usually I find it quite boring watching stuff going on in
well,
the Commons.
So you saw all 12 hours, did you?
Oh, yeah, fully, twice.
Good.
And it did make me think, this proves that big issues are best left to politicians rather than thick people like me.
I don't agree.
Okay.
I don't agree. I think that obviously you've got MPs, I'm an MP, who are elected by people, but generally the way democracy works, as you know, is that it's the voice of the people. And in the referendum, as you know, that was it was 33 million people, I think.
So why don't we do everything by referendum?
Because logistically it would be very difficult to do that. If you know, we do lots of bills like the Criminal Justice Bill, but if sometimes constitutionally the Prime Minister or Parliament feels that it's, if it's such a big question, it's up to the people to decide.
But the thing is, if it was just down, you know, it's not just down to logistics. But voters like me,
yeah,
like the idea,
yeah,
of electing someone like you,
yeah, I get that,
a well-educated, thoughtful person who is spending more time,
sure,
reflecting on, analysing, researching the big issues,
yeah, that's
to make decisions. It better informed decisions than I possibly could. So I will vote for someone based on their values and personality.
Sure.
And then say to them, go make these decisions. I don't feel qualified. I haven't got the time.
No, I think, but what's happened over the time, over a few decades, is that there have been certain questions, and I think it's perfectly right to do this, where you have big constitutional questions. And all across Europe, in all the countries, they've had referendums on the EU, on the EEC. We had a referendum in 1975 to ratify our joining the EEC. And it was right. I mean, in 1975, I was born in 1975, so I didn't have a vote. I'm
Me
41
too.
Years. And you, so, you know, snap. And what we felt was that this question of Europe, our membership with Europe, had bubbled for such a long time that the only way to get some sort of resolution was a referendum. And you all know there was even a referendum party 20 years ago. So this issue of a referendum about Europe has been bubbling away for decades.
I thought Ken Clark's speech was the best one during the debate. Everyone seemed to like it. Moving, why can't all Tories be nice like him?
Well, let me tell you about Ken Clark's speech. He's a senior guy, so he got 22 minutes.
Yeah.
The House indulged him. The Speaker said he was the first
it
one
was
off.
A cracking
Everyone
speech.
Else was limited to, I mean, some of the people yesterday were limited to 3 minutes.
Yeah.
And
most,
Ken is a
most
great
Most MPs are boring speakers.
No, you're right. He's
give
a natural.
Him more because
No.
Yeah.
I mean, I just wanted to put that out there. He was given a huge amount of time. But he's an engaging speaker. He's a funny guy. I mean, I like him very much. I happen to disagree with him quite strongly on this issue. But he's always been very kind. He's very helpful to younger MPs. And it's a real credit that he's stayed around and led the debate.
He's one of the nice Tories. That's why everyone always sort of liked him, regardless of their own, you know,
as opposed to the evil ones.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I mean, you know, nowadays there's a lot of Tories who will masquerade as being compassionate. You know, Theresa May with her shared society and all that. But I like you because you've on many times sort of been quite willing to be openly heartless. You know, you believe in, like a proper Tory from the Thatcher and Tebbit era, you believe in the feckless poor, don't you?
I don't believe so much in the feckless poor. I mean, that's quite a harsh thing. I believe in very open debate. That's why I'm here. I like debate. And I think people have got to be honest about the problems we face.
In your book, Britannia Unchained, you said that British people are lazy and prefer a lie-in to hard work. But everyone prefers a lie-in.
Yeah, no, it's true.
Even
like,
you.
That was yeah, yeah.
You love a lie-in, don't you?
Of course, we all love a lie-in.
But it did suggest to me, here's a good old-fashioned Tory who openly believes that all those people on benefits, the disadvantaged, are just lazy.
No, the book was a provocative book. That's why you quote it. I'm glad that you did. But actually, it was addressing a serious question about productivity, about people's motivation. And I think, again, I believe in being honest. We've got to ask ourselves questions. We can't just pretend everything's hunky-dory, as they've done in Europe and other countries. I think there are grave problems. And I think the responsibility of politicians, young politicians, all politicians, is to actually try and provide solutions, identify problems, talk honestly about them, and try and provide answers. And sometimes that's difficult. Sometimes you say things that people don't want to hear.
Just lastly, I was amazed when I was looking through your biography and wildly impressed that you won University Challenge in 1995.
I knew that would come up.
Did you feel like you had peaked? Is it going to be hard to ever top that?
Do you know what? The fact it was 20 years ago, 22 years ago now, and the fact that you brought it up answers the question. I don't think I'll
You're never going to beat it.
I'm never going to get
Even
it.
Even if you become Prime Minister. Would you like to be Prime Minister one
day?
Yeah,
why not?